रेडी स्टार्ट। द लर्नेड ट्रायल कोर्ट डिसमिस्ड द सूट फाइल्ड बाय द ओरिजिनल प्लेंटिफ एंड रिफ्यूज टू ग्रांट परमानेंट इंजंक्शन एंड अलाउड द काउंटर क्लेम ऑफ द डिफेंडेंट ऑन द ग्राउंड दैट ओरिजिनल प्लेंटिफ कुड नॉट प्रूव द एग्रीमेंट टू सेल डेटेड 23/3/1996 एंड दैट द ओरिजिनल प्लेंटिफ इज इन अनऑथराइज्ड पोजीशन ऑफ द सूट प्रॉपर्टी सिंस 8/7/1997 स्टॉप। द लर्नेड ट्रायल कोर्ट आल्सो हेल्ड दैट द ओरिजिनल प्लेंटिफ कुड नॉट प्रूव द एग्रीमेंट टू सेल फॉर अ सेल कंसिडरेशन ऑफ रूपीज 14,000 एंड आल्सो कुड नॉट प्रूव दैट सी वॉज पुट इन पोजीशन ऑफ द सूट प्रॉपर्टी ऑन 23/3/1996 स्टॉप पैरा। Feeling aggrieved and dissatisfied with the judgment and decree passed by the learned trial court dismissing the suit of the original plaintiff and allowing the counter claim of the defendant, comma, the original plaintiff preferred an appeal before the first appellate court stop. The learned first appellate court allowed the said appeal and set aside the judgment and decree passed by the learned trial court and consequently decreed द सूट फॉर परमानेंट इंजंक्शन अगेन द डिफेंडेंट स्टॉप। द लर्नेड फर्स्ट अपलेट कोर्ट आल्सो डिसमिस द काउंटर क्लेम ऑफ द डिफेंडेंट स्टॉप पैरा। फीलिंग एग्रीव्ड एंड डिससेटिस्फाइड विद द इम्प्यून जजमेंट एंड ऑर्डर पास्ड बाय द हाई कोर्ट इन डिसमिसिंग द सेकेंड अपील एंड कन्फर्मिंग द जजमेंट एंड डिक्री पास्ड बाय द लर्नेड फर्स्ट अपलेट कोर्ट कॉमा decreeing the suit for permanent injunction and dismissing the counter claim, comma, the original defendant has preferred the present appeal, stop para. Learned counsel appearing on behalf of the appellant, original defendant has vehemently submitted that the original plaintiff filed a suit for permanent injunction slowly on the basis of the agreement to sell dated 23/3/1996, comma, which, comma, as such, comma, was unregistered, stop para. It is submitted that such an unregistered agreement to sell is not admissible in evidence, stop. It is submitted that therefore both, comma, the learned first appellate court as well as the high court have committed a grave error in passing a decree for permanent injunction and dismissing the counter claim, stop para. It is further submitted that both, comma, the learned first appellate court as well as the high court have not properly appreciated the fact that the suit filed by the original plaintiff was only for permanent injunction and C, by adopting a clever drafting, did not seek the relief for specific performance of agreement to sell as C was well aware that she would not succeed in the suit for specific performance on the basis of an unregistered agreement to sell. It is submitted that when the original plaintiff cannot get the substantive relief of specific performance of the unregistered agreement to sell dated 23/3/1996, she would not be entitled to a decree for permanent injunction on the basis of such an unregistered document, stop para. It is vehemently submitted that as per the settled position of law, comma, an unregistered document can be used for collateral purpose and therefore both, comma, the first appellate court as well as the high court have rightly passed a decree for permanent injunction restraining the defendant from interfering with her position, comma, considering the agreement to sell dated 23/3/1996 for collateral purpose of grant of permanent injunction.